Yeah, hi, hello student, welcome back. Today we are going to learn new lesson that is called Introduction to Visual Basic. This is class 8 and lesson number 6. Topics are going to be covered in this lesson are Introduction, Features of Visual Basic, Event Driven Programming, Form Window, Properties Window, Code Window, Label and Text Box, Command Button, Written First VB Program, Writing First VB Program, Using Val Function, Performing Simple Calculation, The Code, Saving Visual Basic Project. So let us have a look. First one is Introduction. Visual Basic is a third generation event driven programming language and integrated development environment, that is IDE, from Microsoft. Visual Basic is relatively easy to learn and use. Visual Basic was developed from the basic and enables the rapid application development RAD of graphical user interface GUI application. That means it is a program where all the persons like users can easy to learn and use, and this is derived from the basic programming language. Like before the QBasic there is a basic, so from the basic programming languages. So next one is it is a graphical user interface. That means it is by these programs everyone can access this application. For example, a notepad is there. That means notepad can use everyone. WordPad is there, like MS Office is there. That means everyone can use easily. So these all applications are done in Visual Basic only. Features of Visual Basic. Like the basic programming language, Visual Basic was designed to accommodate beginner programmers. So programming can not only create the simple GUI application but can also develop complex application. Programming in Visual Basic is combining of visually arranging components or controls on the form, specifying the attributes and actions for these components and writing additional lines of the codes for the more functionality. For example, see, by using Visual Basic we can create forms. Forms means which kind of online forms. If you observe the ticket reservations, flight tickets, bus tickets, cinema tickets, or any applications you are using in the form. If there is Facebook is there, you are writing there how to create account, you are writing first name, last name. Those kind of all the applications we can create, and we need to place the buttons, labels and text boxes, and we need to write code for that functions. We need to write code for the text boxes, labels and buttons. So then only it will work. Event driven programming. That means events are the actions that performed by the user during the application usage. If the user clicks a mouse on any object, then click event occurs. That means suppose you are click here to open. When you click that one, that click event will be occurred. That click action will be occurred. That is called event. Event means when a user performed by the any action during the application. That is called event. If a user moves the mouser, then the mouse move event occurs. That means if you are moving the mouse from one place to other place in the system, then mouse move event will occurs. Visual Basic is an event-driven programming language. It is performed set of operations when certain event occurs. So Visual Basic is also an event-driven programming. That means it performs when you keep some certain kind of operation, set of operation, then the certain events will be occurs. For example, if you are moving the mouse moving, that is called event. If you are clicking, that is also a event. If you double clicking, that is also a double clicking event. So those are called events. Visual Basic integrated development. See here, if you observe here, this is the Visual Basic starting page. So here Visual Basic IDE consists of following pans. Recent projects pan, that means it shows the list of projects that you have created recently. That means recently open project. Getting started pan, that means it provides some helpful tips to quick develop your application. Next one is VB Express Headline Pan. It provides the latest online news about the Visual Basic Express. It will announce the new releases and updates. That means it will show what are the new products are coming in the Visual Basic. So that is called, these are the three IDE means integrated development environment. See, so that is called Visual Basic integrated development. creating a new project. To create your first application, we need to go to the first click on file menu. Then select the new project. The new project dialog box will appear as shown in the figure. Select the Windows Form application. At the bottom of the dialog box, you can change the default project name and Windows, some other names like you, for example, my first program. After that, you rename it. Click on OK to continue. So before opening this one, I will show small video how to open this Visual Basic. Yeah, see here, first click on the start button and here Microsoft Visual, see, Visual Basic Studio 2008. I am having the Express version. So I open, this is the that is called interface. How to create a program? So click on file menu. There is a new project here and dialog box appears. Click on the form windows here. You can write the my first project CD. Now click on OK. See. So this is called our Visual Basic interface. This is called form, toolbox, and solution explorer properties. And this is called title bar. So I'm going to show you again. Click on file menu, new project, click on see. After clicking OK, you will get this kind of interface. Next one is form window. Form window means where we will design our application. So it is a user interface where we can use various controls like text box, labels, etc. These controls can be used to enter data and perform actions according to instructions. That means form means it is a where we can design our application. That is called form. Next one is toolbox. It provides the various controls like text box, labels, radio buttons, check box, etc. That makes up your Visual Basic application. User interact with the form through the controls of the toolbox. Some of the most commonly tools used are button, label, combo box, list box, picture box, text box, and many more. That means toolbox which contains tools, so where we can work on the form. Next one is properties window and coding window. Properties window is used to provide the specific characteristics of an object. That means where we can see the properties of an object. For example, you can see the label properties, like you can change the background color, font, text, etc. Whereas coding window is used to write the code of our application. To open the code window, we need to double click on the form or any object in the form. Next one is Solution Explorer. Solution Explorer provides you with an organizer view of your projects and their files. All the forms in your VB application are displayed in hierarchical view, much like that of Windows Explorer. By default, Solution Explorer is located in the right side of the integrated development environment. If Solution Explorer is not visible, you can click the View menu and then click on Solution Explorer to open it. When you create a new Windows applications, by using the Visual Basic Express, a Windows application Solution Explorer appears on the Solution Explorer. The Solution Explorer contains two nodes, My Project and Form VB, whereas the following diagram shows. That means in Solution Explorer, you can see your project. What are the project you are doing? For example, you are doing one project and it contains about that project contains the details. Suppose Windows application 1, it contains My Project and Form 1. That means Form and My Project, it will be contained in Solution Explorer. Next one is labels and text box. Labels are used to display the text that users cannot modify, whereas text box are used to accept the input. That means labels means, see, if you observe the Facebook, there is side, there is first name. First name will be there, and next one, there is side one box is there to enter the first name. So that box is where we are entering our data first name, that is called text box. Where it is displaying that first name, it is, that is called label. So here simply labels are used to display the text and text box is used to accept the input from the user. Some of the common properties of the labels and text box are name of the text box or label, text specifies the text displayed in the text or label, font, it specifies the font name, style, size of the text, align determine the how text is aligned in the label or text, background color and fur color. So this is called labels and text box. Next one is command button. Command button you use it to perform an action. When we click it, some properties of command button are, that means simply after writing your first name and last name and all the details, you will click on the OK. That means OK is the action button, that is called command button. So that is called command button. When you click on OK, it will take to the next page. So OK, submit, these are all called command buttons. Name of the command button, and it is having these properties, text and font. Next one is first program. So how we can create the first program on the Visual Basic? Let us have a look. First we need to drag the label on the form, then we need to go to the properties and set the properties, then the drag the text box also, then we need to place button and we need to write that property as click here, and double click that button we need to write the following code. Message box hello and text box one dot, and this one we need to write. Then see here step 6, click on the run button or press F5 to execute the program. Now let us have a look on a video how to write your first program on the Visual Basic. Yeah, see here, click on file, click on new project and click on Windows form applications, click on OK. See, this is our form where we can work, and this is called toolbox, all the tools where we present. This is called solution explorer. Now where we are exactly in my project, and this is form 1. So this is called solution, and this is called form properties. So whatever, this is called form properties. Now let us see how to create first program. This is called label. See, I drag it and drop, a double click it will come. Okay, now this one is very small. Now there is a properties of label 1. Make sure that if you select form, form properties will come. If you select label, label properties will come. Now I am selecting here and writing that enter your name, and see here, see, and this is my enter your name, and next one whatever it told a text box. See, this is called text box. I am placing here. Now next one what he told, button. See, action button. We need to change these properties also. I'm writing here, click here. Only click is there. Where is remaining one? So we need to expand it. See, now what we need to do? We need to run the program. Now see here, this is the run or click on F5. See, it's running. Now I'm writing that here my name and click here. Nothing is working. Why? Because we did not write any program. This is called only event. Event, mouse click event is there, but no coding is there. So what we will do, we will close this one, and after click this one only we need to get the, so double click the button, and this is called coding window, and this one is called coding window. See here, now I'll write here message box and double quotation. So what should we get? Hello, hello, next, and end symbol, which one? Text box one dot text. So why text box 1? Because see, this is the text box 1 only. So what we need to get, when you click the message box should come hello, text box 1 dot text, this one and this one. So we'll write the program, we'll run the program, let us see. And see here, now I'll write here my name, Tarun Teja, I'm writing here, and click here, see,
Hello Tarun Teja. That means our application is running. So in this way we can create our small applications. So once again I'm showing, this is called labels, this is called text box, this is called buttons, and this one is called form. So this is called run button, this is called solution explorer, this is called properties. You can change the colors also here in the properties, background color or color. See, now it's showing that blue color. In this way we can change the colors also. Next one is val function. Val function is used to convert the string into number. For example, to extract the value stored in the text box, we'll convert it. So I'm going to show one small example here. For example, addition or some kind of that example I'm going to show. So let us have a look on a val function, what it will exactly do. You see here how to create. Click on file menu, click on new project and Windows form applications and click on OK. So here now I'm going to create here, place one number one. You can copy and paste also, and this is called number two, and next one I'm placing three labels. I'm placing now, this is third label, see label three, and I'm writing the total. So here one more, I'll keep three text box. So I want three, so second and third. You can copy paste also. So next one I want to keep here button, so I will write here add. So I click one button here. Now let us run the program. See number one, one and one, and click here to add. If I click this one, it should come 1 + 1 = 2. See, it's not coming. Why? Because we didn't write any program or code to the button. So we'll write the code here. So double click this one. See where we are writing, in button we are writing. So text box, because it should come here, text box 3 only. So here only we need to get the output. Text box 3 dot text is equal to txt, text box 1 dot text plus text box 2 dot text. So let us see, I written, when I click the button, text box 3 dot text. So here this data plus this data should come here. So run here. Now I'll write here 1 and here 1. I'm going to add here, see, 11. How it is played is 11. So suppose if I keep here 10, it should come 11, but 101. That means it is adding directly 10 plus 1. It's like name. If you write here, see, it is coming, Tarun Teja. Like that means it is adding, like it's alphabetic, it is like strings. So these are, it is converting, so numbers also it converting like strings only. See 52 + 3 = 55 and 523 it coming. So what we need to do here, val function will be used, val, val, val. So here also one more val will keep it. See, now run the program. 10 plus 1, it should come 101 or 101 or 11. Now see here, 11. That means it will convert the alphabetics into numbers. So see here, 52 plus 3 = 55. That means now it's functioning. Now it's coming, functioning. In this way, val function is used. See here, val function is used to convert the number alphabetics into numbers. Saving, click on file menu and click on save form 1.vb option, then save dialog, save as dialog box appears. Choose the location where you want to save, write the name of the form and click on the save button. Save project dialog box appears and displayed. Write the project name and click on the save to save the project. Now it's going to show small video about the how to save the project. You see here, click on file, click on save form 1.vb and save it. See, save as, and dialog box appear. Choose the location and write the name and click on the save, then project will be saved. So how to close this one? Click on file menu and click on close project. You want to save, you can save it. I didn't save, so click on and click on the close and project will be closed. Now I'm going to show how to open here. Start button and Microsoft Visual 2008. So in this way you can open the Visual Studio. Okay students, that's all for today's class. Meet you in next class. Till then, take care, stay safe. I hope you like it. Thank you.